That's rude!
Unless she is a ghost.
It may come as a disappointment, but I am alive.
Ah.
That makes you a suspect, I'm afraid.
I know.
What's your name?
My name is Poppy. I'm a pointer. And a pianist.
We'll need to ask you a few questions about Freya.
I know.
Hey, you're pretty good.
All in the wrist. And 13 years of dedicated practice. I'm just me. There's nothing to know.
How are you related to the other pointers?
My father is Percival Pointer. The professor spends most of his time hidden away in his tower. Barely speaks to anyone these days. Especially not the fellows.
Do you get on with the fellows?
Two of them. Fifi and Freya are my closest friends. We all turned 19 last year.
Do people ever leave Tangle Tower? I don't mean to be rude. It's just, if you're 19...
You don't have to answer that, Poppy.
It's a fair question. I'd like to move away. Definitely. Fifi, Freya, and I would often talk about it, argue about it. Freya wanted to leave, but Fifi... Things are more complicated for her.
What about now?
After what happened, I really don't want to stay here much longer. 3.5 hours of piano practice, soon as I wake up. Same as always.
3.5? Does that not hurt your hands?
Sure.
And you do this in the music room?
No, I prefer to practice in my room. When I make mistakes, I like to make them in private.
What did you do after that?
I was supposed to meet Fifi in the library, but I totally forgot. When I finally got down there, she'd already gone. I checked her bedroom, but it was locked.
Was Fifi not in there?
No idea. She keeps her door locked either way. So I went back upstairs and out into the moonlight garden.
The what?
The little garden on the roof outside my room.
Was it just you up there?
No. Fitz came outside after a while. His room's on the other side. He's been teaching me about flowers.
So, did you talk to him?
Not really.
You ignored each other.
I didn't say that. Fitz and I were up in the Moonlight Garden most of the afternoon. Then we heard this sound. Lasted about 3 seconds. I've been trying to decide how to describe it, but I'm struggling. It was like something drilling into a piece of metal, but different. Worse. I was pretty sure it was coming from Flora's tower, so we went up there to check. Her door was locked. Nobody was answering. I knew Freya and Flora were both supposed to be in there, so I made Fitz kick down the door. I went inside. Freya was lying on the floor.
Flora was in the room too?
Yeah. I think she realized what had happened at the same moment I did. I didn't know what to do, so I ran downstairs to get Fifi. Her door was still locked, but I knocked and shouted at her. Eventually, she let me in. The lights were off, but I could see she'd already been crying. I told her what had happened. She didn't believe me. She got angry. First time I've ever seen her angry. I dragged her out into the hall. My father was there too, for some reason. The three of us went back up to Flora's tower. Then Felix arrived. He had Penny with him. Fifi had this idea. She wanted to do some kind of scientific test. She took me down to the library. We were in there about 15 minutes. After she was done, she went back upstairs and I went back to my room.
That's it?
That's it.
Poppy's bedroom is unlocked.
I wonder what's in there. That is the bed of a vampire.
I thought vampires slept in coffins.
This is a vampire who needs firm support for their lower back. That is the bed of a vampire.
I thought vampires slept in coffins.
This is a vampire who needs firm support for their lower back.
It's a metronome for keeping time.
It's ticking. Is it a bomb?
It's supposed to be ticking. Not sure what those symbols are, though. I did it. What do I win?
Not bad. What happened?
Little hatch unlocked in the back.
Anything in there?
Mm-hmm. It's a photograph. Part of a photograph.
Sheet music. Presumably for piano.
It's only a few notes. I'd barely even call that music.
Yeah, it's been framed, though. Must be important for some reason. There's a name for this kind of piano. You know, these ones that stand upright? A single red rose. How very traditional.
Yeah, weird.
Anything in the drawers?
Nothing you need to know about.
Anything in the wardrobe?
Dresses, mostly. I never realized there are so many shades of black.
Just a bunch of clothes on the floor. Nothing weird about that.
To you.
Various handmade posters.
What do you think those symbols mean?
Hopefully, nothing. A big glass door leads out into a garden. Somehow.
There's a little mechanism by the handle.
Something happened.
That must be it. And the door's still locked.
I still feel like we made some sort of progress. It's locked, but it leads outside.
I thought we were halfway up a tower.
We are.
What's that thing by the handle?
It made a noise.
I guess that was right. Finally, it's open.
Whatever's on the other side better be worth it.
Giant stone frog? Love it.
Yeah, he's got his tongue out like he's catching snowflakes.
Except those aren't snowflakes. They're feathers. That's one big dragonfly.
Or one very small dragon. It's another little statue, doing a really bad job of hiding in the bushes.
He's playing a lute this time.
He's also wearing headphones.
Well, they're not part of the statue. And they're not headphones. They're earmuffs.
It's a rose bush, growing on a little patch of bluish soil. Now, apart from a couple of loose petals on one side, the whole thing looks very well cared for.
The roses are bright red, too.
Now, aren't roses normally that color?
Exactly.
A little pond.
It looks really, really deep, for some reason. See those metal bars around the edges, too?
Oh, yeah. What are you supposed they're for?
Nothing anymore. Looks like somebody broke them and then never bothered to fix it. More egg statues.
I don't get it. Why eggs?
Well, either they have some special significance, or the sculptor was just really lazy.
What do you mean?
An egg has got to be the easiest shape to make.
Careful, we're pretty high up.
Yeah, we're on a roof. It's so relaxing. I might just stay here.
Oh, shall I go finish the investigation on my own?
Oh, that'd be great.
It's the window into Fitz's bedroom.
You know, he's pretty lucky. I wish my bedroom window had a view this nice.
The door into Poppy's room.
So, only Poppy and Fitz can get into the garden?
Ah, I guess so. My little writing desk. It's kinda cute.
There's nothing written in the book, although someone's torn a page out of the middle.
Bird diagrams. Hand-painted.
They're beautiful. Someone really knows their stuff.
Bird diagrams.
They're beautiful. Someone really knows their stuff. I don't like mirrors. They steal your soul.
How do you get your hair so symmetrical without using a mirror?
I do it by weight. I can feel if one side is heavier than the other.
I feel like I'm standing in a giant birdcage. An especially fancy cage.
And it's home to three especially fancy birds. They're bird cages, but the birds are coming and going freely.
Is that a metaphor?
Oh, it totally is.
What's those little windows down there?
I think they're there for draining rainwater.
Oh,